Mamma mia, miscia mia, la 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 la, miscia bella, porta bella, la 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 la. Oh, buongiorno! This is SonicBlu Dark Folk for Cooking with SonicBlu. And for the rest of the month, we got some Italian dishes going on that are going to be kind of interesting, kind of out of the ordinary stuff that you wouldn't make every day in the kitchen. Like tonight's recipe, Manicotti. And I'm going to show you how to make this complex recipe. Well, it'll still be complex, but you'll still be able to make it now. You'll be a little wiser about how to do it. Now, what we're doing here is we're grinding up and browning three Italian sausages. We've removed the casings and we've placed it in here. You can also add garlic if you want to, but there's going to be plenty of garlic in this dish. You won't even need it. So all we're going to do with this is brown three Italian sausages. You can use the hot and spicy, the mild, any kind that you want to, as long as it's Italian. Remove the casings so that way you don't have that hard, you know, sort of casing to kind of change the texture, because we want as soft as a mixture as we can get right here. And once it's all browned, we're going to drain off the juices and stick it back in the saucepan so that we can put our marinara sauce in it and mix it all together and make a nice Italian meat sauce. Now, over here, we need a nice big pot like this. It's going to cook our manicotti noodles. You have to be very careful with these, and we're going to be cooking these al dente, which means firm but cooked. So that way the oven can cook them the rest of the way. So once we drop those in, and that looks like it's about done, but what you want to do is when you make manicotti, you do not want to do three things at once, and you're going to have to, but we're going to tackle it one thing at a time. So that way you can keep a good watch on your manicotti noodles and they won't stick, and that's the whole trick about it. Get them to still so they're still firm, get them to cool so they're still firm, so that you can stuff them when they're still firm. Then you stick them in your pan, your dish, your casserole dish, and stick it in the oven, and then you can bake it the rest of the way. But it does have to be al dente, so that way you can stuff them. Now, this is starting to brown up nicely, so what I'm doing is I'm concentrating a little bit on this, getting this out of the way so I can put this down on low and get the marinara started. And once that's out of the way, I won't have to worry about this at all. So, getting this out of the way first, and making sure that it's all brown before the marinara goes in, because you definitely don't want to see red meat there. But we're going to drain it once we are done. And this is actually might not even need to be drained much, because it didn't produce that much juices. I must have gotten the fat-free kind, or the lower fat kind, which I didn't think there was
much fat
getting sausage like that, because usually it juices up like crazy. So once this is done, we're going to drain it anyway, just to see how much juices are in it, because you want to have little juice as possible in your marinara sauce. And that way it's more healthy for you, it's less fattening, and you can eat a lot of it and you still won't grow big as Cousin Luigi, you know, the one with the big ass mustache that makes pizzas all day long. To prepare your manicotti making, you're going to need a lot of counter space. We'll go over here. We got our cheeses up here. That's how much we're going to need in counter space. Over here, we have our tin foil. We're going to be draining off the manicotti in here, cooling it down, and then adding some olive oil to prevent them from sticking, and we're going to stick them right here to cool. Now, over here, we got our spinach. Over here, we got our manicotti. Over here, we got our olive oil. Let's go ahead and use a little dollop of olive oil right in our water. This ensures that your manicotti will not stick when it's boiling, and that's important. Do not let it stick, because it gets very sticky. Now, over there, we got our chopped spinach. In the chopper, we have our garlic and mushroom mix, and that's going to go into the ricotta cheese, which we have right here. And we got two eggs over there. We got all of our spices there. So you are going to need lots of counter space and lots of coordination to make manicotti. But do it one thing at a time, because the novice will not be able to do all three. Let's go over here to the colander and carefully extract the juices and greases and all that fattening stuff that's left behind. All right, now, if you want to, for an extra added measure, you can rinse your pan. In fact, let's do that. Rinse this out. Make sure none of the juices are in there. And that's okay, you don't have to worry about washing it out, because the sausage is going to go back into it anyway. Now, very carefully shake, because the holes on this colander are small enough to where some of that meat will escape. You don't want that to happen. So, gonna give it a nice firm shake like this, a nice gentle shake, not a firm one, but a nice gentle one like this. Because, as you can see, little piece there, little piece there, piece there, piece there. It does slip through the holes, so you want to make sure that a lot of those juices are extracted from your sausage. This will make it nice and healthy. And keep doing this until all the juices are no longer present. And you'll notice that there are less and less juices dripping out of the bottom of your colander. And I think that just about does it. So, carefully place your sausage back into the saucepan, and you will notice that this is nice and dry. And look, you got a lot of your greases is still coated your colander like that. And we're going to rinse that out before the noodles go into it. So we don't want this getting back into our noodles. The only oil we want in there is olive oil, not sausage oil. So rinse this out real good. Now that you got this back on, let's turn this down to a low of 1 to 2, very low, and add your marinara. Now, I can't stress enough how people can open jars just as easily by whacking it at the bottom of your jar, and now my hand is all greasy, so now. Okay, prevent that from burning up. Aha, there we go. There we go. You don't need a jar opener. Just whack it a couple of times at the bottom there. You don't need a jar opener. It's so simple. Pour your marinara in and give it a good stir, and let the simmering keep this stuff warm. And don't worry about it splattering either. You'll have it on a very, very low setting. Because what we want to do is we want to slow cook our marinara. And make sure that all of the marinara is in there. Give it a nice good shake, make sure it's all in there. And marinara sauce is very thin and very basic. All it is just the basic stuff needed to make a sauce. That's what your marinara is in. And different ingredients do different spices, make it taste different. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take our spoon again and we're going to stir the marinara into our sausage. Make sure that it is all nice, one big nice mix. Just like that. And this is what's going to go into our manicotti. Once you've got it all mixed in there, leave it sit and just let it cook on very low. Over here we got our pot, and here we got our skillet. So what we're going to do here is we're going to save this for last. And what we're going to do is just get it ready with a little dollop of olive oil, just enough to coat the bottom of your skillet. And you need a medium-sized skillet for this part. Let that stay. We're not even heating this up yet. We're going to concentrate on our noodles. So, we got 8 manicotti noodles, which will be 4 servings per person. It can be 3, but we're hungry. And you can have that extra manicotti noodle for the extra person. So, get as many of these as you can and drop them down all at the same time, so that way they all come up at the same time. And this is, I don't recommend doing it like this, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Make sure they don't overlap. You don't want these to overlap because what's on the bottom will crush. 7, one more, 8. Now, they're all at the bottom there. You need something like this for 8 manicotti noodles. And the reason why you don't want any of these to crush. Now, look at the time, 8:50. We're going to pull these up at 8:56 on the nose because then that'll be al dente. We're going to take these, we're going to run them off into the colander, we're going to rinse them off with cold water, and add some olive oil while we're mixing them in so that way they don't stick. And then transfer them right away from the colander over to your tin foil so they'll cool down. And then you can concentrate on making your ricotta cheese. Now, for the ricotta cheese, what we're going to be using are 2 eggs. We're going to use some of this peppercorn, margarine, basil, spinach, and ricotta cheese, and this stuff here, which is 6 ounces of mushroom and 1 clove of garlic. But since we're doubling up on the recipe, I'm using this entire tub of ricotta cheese. Now, that's 30 ounces of ricotta right there, but you only need 15 for just this one serving that we're doing here. So we're going to make this, and the reason why we're making so much ricotta cheese is that next time I'm going to show you how to stuff your jumbo shells and make jumbo shells just like this. But it's basically, here's your mushroom mix, and you want to kind of get your mushroom kind of like nice and chunky. You know, not too chunky, but you can see that the garlic's in there, mushrooms are in there, beautiful mix. Alright, so now, it's 8:51. Really concentrate on this and try not to move them around too much too, unless you're ready to pull them up. And when you do, you pull them right up with just a regular spoon, like this. And when they're ready, you're just going to dip your spoon in and kind of lift them up like that, but they're not ready yet and I shouldn't have done that just yet. But just to give you an example of how we're going to do this, and you want to make sure to keep your manicotti separate from each other. They don't stick. These are very sticky noodles, so you'd have to definitely be very, very careful. Now, you definitely don't want to do anything that'll tear your manicotti, but in case you do, and I know nobody's perfect here, but in case you do tear your manicotti, you can split it down the middle and then stuff it with cheese and then roll it back up again. Nobody will ever know. but we're going to try to do it the traditional Italian way without breaking our manicotti. We're going to take the spinach and we're going to chop this up, and I'm going to show you how to do that after we do these noodles. And it's 8:52. I'm keeping my eye on the time, making sure it doesn't cook too much. We just need to cook these al dente so that the oven will cook them up the rest of the way. And what we're going to do is get our casserole dish. We're going to line the bottom of it with this marinara. Then we're going to take the ladle and drizzle it over the stuffed manicottis, so that way when they go in there, they'll be nice and saucy. And also, we're going to take some mozzarella and top it over the top of that with some Parmesan. So, we got a lot of good stuff going your way. If you never tried manicotti before, wait till you try this. So,
and we were waiting for 6 minutes, right?
Yes.
So we got about two more minutes.
So keep checking the consistency of your noodle. You definitely don't want to overcook these. And if they seem like they're softening up a bit, leave them in there just a little bit more, because they're not quite there yet. Not quite. Let me see this guy, because you're right over the flame. Okay, that one might be ready to come up. You'll notice that they'll be a lot more delicate. You'll notice that some of them might actually be cracked before you throw them in here. But you just gotta be very careful when cooking your manicotti. Be very, very gentle. This is a very delicate procedure. So 2 more minutes in the water and it should do fine. You need to boil it in the medium-most setting right here at number 5 when you cook these noodles. Now, it's 8:55 now. So
let us just... Might be able to take them out now.
We might be able to take them out. Yes, we will. That is perfect. These are al dente. Take them right off the fire. And right into, carefully now, do it the right way, just very carefully, very, very delicate. All right, got it, okay. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take our manicottis here, get rid of that, and we're gonna cool it down like this. Just run some water over it, very gentle, very, very gentle. You don't even wanna shake this too much, because enough of this pressure and it will... Okay, now what we're gonna do, we're grabbing our olive oil here. And we're just gonna give it a little dollop here. Okay, like that. And then we're just gonna move it around a bit like this. It might still be hot though, because you just use a little bit of cold water just to cool it down. So, once they're coated with your noodles, they'll stick a lot less. And you can still feel how firm they are, but they're cooked. That's called al dente. So remember that lesson, folks. If you ever do al dente cooking, you'll need to know that term and what it means. There's 4. I get these guys because these were on the bottom and I'm worried about these guys. 6, 7, and 8. Some of these have already been split before they went into the water, so there's some things you just can't avoid. 4 manicotti noodles will fill a typical hungry person. 3 is normal. So, remember that.
Yeah, that filled me up rather easily with all that. It was actually good.
Let's move this over to the front now. And we're going to turn this on a very low, so that way when we work on our spinach, this will be heating up. Now, what we're going to do is first, we're going to take our mushroom mixture of mushroom and garlic and just toss that right into the skillet here with the oil. And use your finger to get all that rest of that stuff out of there. I'm going to take the spoon here. Now, we'll use the same spoon as we're using for this. I mean, it doesn't really matter. And you just need a little bit of oil, just enough. We're going to saute our garlic and mushroom mixture for 5 minutes. Let's actually turn this up a bit. Now, when it becomes starts to become brown, then you're ready to add your chopped spinach. So while this is heating up, let's go ahead and chop our spinach, and I'll show you exactly how to do it. Now, a lot of people are intimidated with knives, but it's real simple to cut your vegetables. Just remember a very simple formula. Do not cut your fingers. What we're going to do is we're going to shred our spinach. Okay, be very careful not to cut your fingers. And once it's all shredded, this is about 6 ounces of spinach. We got the extra spinach in case we need it, because we are doubling up on our recipe here. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take all of this, turn it to the side, and then with your right hand here, left hand holding the knife handle, and we're going to do like this. Okay, this hand is always going to be flat. Hold it by the palm of your hand like this. Because this is proper control of a knife when you chop vegetables. And you must remember to keep a good hold with the knife handle with your left hand. And remember to keep your fingers flat out like this, because you don't want to make a mistake and actually accidentally cut one of your fingers. That would not be good, especially if you just sharpened the blade. But just be very careful to chop your spinach up just like that. And if there's some long shreds, go ahead and chop them down if you want to. But I feel that if you went and grabbed some of these shreds of spinach and set these guys aside, and I did that on purpose, so that way when we take the spinach shreds, we can top it over the top and make a really good garnish for your presentation. Okay, and now, that is good chopped spinach right there, and that's about 6 ounces there. What I'm gonna also do is I'm gonna also make some extra shredded spinach, and I'm just gonna shred this, or at least part of this. I'm gonna shred part of this, so that way we'll have plenty of a garnish. It will look good. It will look like you just picked it up from the Italian bistro down the street, and nobody will know you made it yourself. Now, let's take a look really quick at our sauté. And it's starting to brown up nicely. Keep stirring this occasionally, and always best to use a nonstick, so that way all of this stuff, you won't lose any of it, and you don't have to use so much oil, because the nonstick will help keep it from sticking. So use a nonstick skillet. And do like this number here, too. There you go. This smells really good, folks. I don't know if you've ever had good manicotti before, but if you have not, then I definitely recommend this recipe to anybody. If you just follow exactly along with what I'm doing here, then you can't possibly go wrong. Check up on our mushroom and garlic mixture. For about 5 minutes, this will be sautéing. Then we can add our spinach, just like it is, and cook it for 5 more minutes. So we started this at about 3 minutes ago. We got 2 more minutes to go. Just make sure it's nice and sautéed and get this really, really cooking up. Really, you can really smell. And you don't even have to add anything to this because the garlic is the strongest flavor you have in your skillet. You don't need to add anything else to it because anything else to it will just be hidden by the garlic. Yeah, because garlic is that strong. You don't need anything else in here, not even peppercorns. All right, are we ready for our spinach? Yes, we are. Let's grab some shredded spinach and just kind of toss it right in here. There we go. We don't need much, but since we are making a double supply, we do need at least 8 ounces of spinach. And just mix it all in. Stir it all in good. You want to make sure your spinach is somewhat cooked. And we're going to cook this for another 5 minutes. So keep it at the same heat. Stir this around and make sure it stays cooking for 5 minutes, and that way it'll be ready for being mixed into the ricotta cheese. Now, once you get it all mixed around, give it a shake so that way it evens out in the pan. Then, what we're going to do is take a couple of eggs and beat them in this big bowl. So now we've got the space for it. So you do this a little bit at a time, and it'll give you a little bit more counter space to work with. Make sure you don't have any eggshells in here either. And just take a couple of eggs. That was good. And egg number two. That was good too. I don't see any shells. Good. Alright. Now, mix. Use a whisk and start beating those eggs. We're going to lightly beat the eggs because you don't really need to mix this really all that well. We're just going to mix this in. It'll all get mixed in with the ricotta cheese and everything. And that's it. That's all you need to do. Okay, put the rest away. You don't need that anymore. Let's go back over here to our spinach. Now, if you can do this easily, folks, then you can make manicotti. I will show you the way. Okay. I think that's about ready. So, turn that off. Set that aside to let it cool. Now, we got this. We got this. We got the ricotta. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add half of this jug. Avocado cheese would go for one serving, but we're going to use the whole thing because, like I said, we're going to need the extra ricotta cheese for the next recipe as well. So making all of this ricotta is definitely necessary for what we got to do next time. Get as much out of there as you can. Set it aside and start mixing it around with the egg. You'll notice that it will liquidify just a bit, but If you have enough going in here, everything will mix together in a perfect way. So that way when you add your mix to this, it shouldn't be too runny nor too firm. And we're using plenty of manicotti and plenty of egg. And if you find that one thing just doesn't seem right against the other, it shouldn't be too bad. I mean, what you were looking for is a nice glop of cheese, like this. Make sure it's all mixed in there really good, because you'll notice that your egg won't really mix very well in your manicotti here. I'm sorry, manicotti. In your ricotta cheese. But just make sure you give it a really, really, really good mix. And as you see, two eggs is perfect for that. Look at that. That's what we want right there. Makes it easier for stuffing, but it also... Now if you want to, too, if you want a thicker cheese, only add one egg. And for an extra added bonus, you can actually chill this in the refrigerator. Now, we're going to take that spoon there and just hope it doesn't sink too far. We're going to take our mixture of spinach, mushroom, and garlic. Drop it right in here, right like that. Getting as much of that stuff in there as possible. So that way everything mixes together, everything's evenly distributed, everything looks smashingly good. Okay, we're not going to get 100% of our mixture in there, but that's okay. Take your spoon, and now we're going to mix all of this together in the ricotta cheese. And as you can see, it's going to be mixed evenly. Get all the way around, make sure it's mixed as well and thoroughly as possible, because you don't want any of your stuff here, your mixture, to go without any spinach, any mushroom, garlic, any of that stuff. You really got to mix this in good until you see that all of your spinach here is evenly distributed. Just look at that. Look at that, huh? That is good ricotta. Now, while we are waiting for the manicotti to cool down, we're going to chill this in the refrigerator. It's probably about a good 5 minutes, if you can find room in your refrigerator. Okay, stay. I put the stay spell on it. It should be good. Since we kept our marinara sauce at 2, it is nice and cooked and nothing splattered out of it. You see that? What we're going to do is take it right over here to our casserole dish, and we want something of this size. We get like a 9 by 11 or 9 by 11 and a half or whatever this size is, and just line it on the bottom here. Now kind of like spread this around a bit. You want to cover the bottom of this. Okay, that would be perfect. The rest of this is going to drizzle over the top. So let's put this back over in here. Still at 2, still heating up. Now, here's our ricotta cheese. It's a little bit firmer, as you can see. And what we're going to do, take the manicotti noodle and take the part that's not cracked. Put it right there against your palm. Hold it up with your fingers. And just pour your manicotti into the noodle until all of the ricotta cheese... Pour your manicotti into the noodle, did I say that? Pour the ricotta cheese into your noodle. And if you feel the cheese is coming out the other end, your palm will stop it from oozing all over the place, and then just fill it the rest of the way and just drop it right into your casserole dish. Very simple and easy. Now, as I can feel it, the cheese is starting to dribble out the other side, so I got to reposition it. And then this one's being a bit of a pain because of that crack being there, and it's not wanting to hold this noodle open for the task, so you got to kind of help it along with a spoon here. And while you maintain the other end from preventing any more ricotta cheese from seeping out the other end, and there you go. Okay, now, what we're going to do now is we're going to cover this, so we're going to use the same piece of tinfoil that we used and cover over it. But first, what we're going to do is we're going to come back for our sauce. And this is almost done, folks, and this is how you make manicotti. We're going to do this. Just drizzle this right over the top there, just right back and forth, just like that. Doesn't have to cover it. Like that, kind of like evenly distribute it, as evenly as possible. And you got just enough sauce to do this over the top, right over here, right over here. Beautiful, magnificent, magnifique, magnifico, however you want to say it. Use all your sauce. Don't just throw the rest of this away. All of this stuff can go in here. And then you'll be ready for your cheese. Here's where I like to add a little bit of magic. Take your basil. and with the shaker side, shake a little bit of basil over the top, just like that. So that way there's a nice rich Italian flavor when you bite into this. Before the cheese goes on it, shake the basil around like that. And for an extra added kick, marjoram. Take a little bit of marjoram too. And it doesn't take that much. I just put it in here so that way I don't use too much. But just take a pinch and just go over the top with marjoram and basil, just like that. A little bit over here in the center too, because we didn't get enough over there. There. We're going to take our mozzarella cheese first and just kind of drizzle it right over where you see the sauce, right like this. We get a lot of cheese there. Take your shredded Parmigiana and just sprinkle a little bit of Parmesan over at the top of this. Oh yes. Get it all over like that. Che portabello, che magnifica, mwah. All right. 375 start, preheat. We're gonna take this, that is held, our manicotti noodles. We're gonna recycle it. Flip it over and cover your casserole dish in foil. Make sure it's tight. Don't make it so tight to where it tears, but tight enough where it will cover your manicotti. And why we cover this? So that way your manicotti doesn't dry out and your cheese doesn't come out too well done right away. Because we're going to be baking this for 30 minutes and you will need to cover this for the entire duration. Except at the end when we pull it off and cook it another 10. So that way your manicotti will firm, or not really firm, but it will cook up. Your cheese will be perfectly coated with your manicotti. And we're just going to cook it for 30 minutes. We'll come back after 30 minutes. Then we're going to cook it for 10. We're going to come back, we're going to show you the finished results and make a lovely presentation for any of your family and friends. And if you do it just the way I do, with the garnish, you will make yourself an Italian chef overnight. And also, we're going to take some of these spinach leaves and put them on the plate for decoration. It's time, and we're going to pull our manicottis. Ooh, look at this. Delicious looking, look at that. Oh. Inside all of that sauce and cheese is our manicotti. And we have just prepared and mastered our manicotti dish. Now let this cool for a little bit before you serve it, because look, it's still bubbling there. And you get all of this cheese and all of this. You look at this ricotta cheese coming out right there and right there. And it is just wonderfully looking. If you can get it to look like this, because that's why we only take just a little bit of sauce and drizzle it over, because you'll get plenty when it starts to thin out in the baking process. But look at this. Now when we serve this up, this is going to be some dynamite Italian cuisine. Now we've also made it look very professional by putting some spinach leaves on the side of your plate. And we're going to line our manicotti like this. And then we're going to garnish it off the top with some just a little bit of chopped spinach over the top of it to give it some green for color. And then, but not before, we top it with some pepper from the pepper mill. So let's go ahead and do that while it's cooling. And there you go. Doesn't take that much. A little bit over here too. There we go. Now the peppercorns will give it a nice robust flavor when you get to serve this stuff. And that's how you make Italian manicotti. We're going to serve this up here, so to move this along, we're going to carefully go in with a spatula, place the manicotti over here, very carefully. You might lose some of the ricotta cheese there. That's okay if you do. You just take it, stuff it right back in there. There we go. Let's go in for number two, maybe even number two and three if you can get them all in the same one. Oh, that lost some more of the cheese there, but that's all right. Just stuff it back. Nobody will ever know if you're the one serving this up. Because this does get kind of, as Kraft for some reason is a lot smoother than the generic. I know, consumer, I got generic. Well, that's your fault then. See, your dishes didn't turn out the way you thought. Cry me a river, consumer. Be very careful not to touch this because it's going to be very hot. Serve it up like that and there you go. Excellent. You see the basil and marjoram right there and baked right in there. Put some of this ricotta cheese right over there. Now, might not look like much, but it'll taste really awesome. And just add a little bit of spinach over the top of this for flavor and color. And that is how you make a delicious Italian cuisine out of just simple. Well, nothing about this recipe is simple, but we just mastered an Italian cuisine, and look at that presentation. Now, you present this to your family and friends, and they're going to think that you just took this home from the Italian restaurant. This is what we call good Italian cooking, and we just mastered the art of making manicotti right here before your very eyes. This is some good stuff. Hello, Wolf Dog. Are you ready to try some manicotti?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, we got the manicotti there, and it looks like you are definitely attempting to eat what I have worked so hard in the kitchen to prepare. And this is why Italian mothers are so adamant about their children eating right.
Yeah, no kidding.
So, your first bite of some good prepared Italian tradition manicotti. Watch out, because it's going to be real hot. And the verdict.
Oh, it is very good.
Oh, yes. Would you ever believe that was prepared in the home?
It tastes as good as you would find probably in a restaurant, I would think.
Yep, restaurant quality manicotti. And all of this can be your cuisine too, if you just follow along with exactly what I did. Well, maybe not to the T, but you want to follow it along as good as possible to present yourself and your family with a beautiful looking meal like this. Italian manicotti. And if I can make it, so can you. You can download the recipe at our website at www.ohiopopettes.org and try it sometime. It's very extensive. It shows you step by step on how to make this meal that you just saw here tonight. And I'd encourage everybody to at least try something different in the kitchen, because you never know what you can turn into if you just apply yourself to it. I've been SonicBlu Darkfold, and this has been Cooking with SonicBlu. And on behalf of the O Popette Show, let's go back to the live set. And remember, if you're not cooking good, you're not eating good. But make sure that you got the right ingredients in order to cook good so that you can eat good.
For complete recipes, send an email to sonicblu@yahoo.com. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you're not cooking good, you're not eating good. Bye for now.